My name's Isabel Gracia. I'm a student of physical therapy. I'll be working with you today. How are you doing?
I'm good.
Good, good. So I just wanted to let you know how today's going to go. It's going to be about 10 to 15 minutes. I'm going to run you through a series of questions. First, we're going to talk about just some of your background information, what you do for a living, just so I could get to know you a little bit better. And then we're going to move down to what exactly is bothering you and how I could best help you with that. Okay, sound good? Good. Do you have any questions for me so far?
No.
Okay, great. Thank you. So just to start off, I just want to verify your last name. Could you spell that out for me?
Sure. It's Corona, like the beer. It's C-O-R-O-N-A.
Okay, nice. Do you like Corona?
Yeah, I've had a few.
Okay, nice. And how old are you?
I'm 19.
19, okay. Great. And have you, do you have any experience with physical therapy at all?
Well, I did hurt my left knee when I was 10 years old going down a slip and slide, and I actually dislocated it. And I did have to go through a lot of PT, and it was really terrible. I didn't like it at all.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. And that was when you were 10?
10. Yeah, okay. So I was just a kid.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sorry that you, sounds like you had a bad experience with physical therapy, but I want you to know that I'm going to do my best today to not recreate that experience for you so that I can best help you with what you're going through. So let's talk about just what you do for a living.
Well, I push around a cart at Fiesta, Texas.
Okay.
And I sell snow cones to people when they're thirsty. And I kind of go around the whole park and just ask people if they need something.
Okay. And is this a full-time job or a part-time job?
It's part-time.
Part-time?
Yeah.
Okay, so about how many hours would you say you work a week?
Well, it's really Friday through Sunday, mostly because I do go to school at a community college. So it's just part-time.
Okay, and you're a part-time student as well or a full-time student?
I'm a full-time student.
Full-time? Okay.
Yeah. At a community college.
Community college. What are you going to school for?
I want to be a fashion designer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice, nice. Awesome. Okay, and aside from school and work, is there anything that you do for fun or?
Well, I like to dance a lot.
Okay.
With my friends on the weekend.
Yeah, okay, nice. And what's your favorite music to dance to?
Mostly salsa.
Salsa. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Cool. And is there anything that you do for exercise? Maybe besides dancing.
Besides dancing, well, I would consider that exercise, I guess. But besides that, no, not really.
Okay. Okay. And about how many times do you think you dance?
Pretty much every weekend.
Every weekend?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Friday through Sunday.
Right, yeah.
Nice, okay. And how long of a walk would you say that you walk to and from your classes?
You know, even though it's a community college, it's smaller, but I do walk a lot. It's,
okay.
It's on the opposite end. So
okay.
It's,
so there's a lot of walking involved?
Yeah, sometimes I'm late.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. So, as far as your living situation, do you live in a house or an apartment?
I live at home with my mother and grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
It's a two-story home, and it's just us three.
Okay. So, two-story home. There's stairs in the home, I assume. And is there any stairs to get up to the entrance of the home and the porch or anything like that?
Not to get into my home, but I do have to go up the stairs to my bedroom.
Okay.
That's what you mean?
Your bedroom's upstairs.
Yeah.
Okay. Is your bathroom upstairs?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bathrooms,
yeah,
upstairs.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, could you point to me where your leg pain is today?
Yeah. So, I hurt my left ankle.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really just right on it and a little bit above it.
Okay. Just
yeah.
On the ankle and above.
Right.
So, on a scale from 0 to 10, 10 being the very worst pain that you felt, and 0 being how would you rate your pain right now as you're sitting?
Right now, I'd say it's a 1 out of 10.
1, okay. Mm-hmm. And at its worst, how would you rate that?
At its worst, I'd say an 8 out of 10.
8.
Mm-hmm.
And at its best?
0 out of 10.
0, okay.
Mm-hmm.
And in your own words, how would you describe that pain that you feel there?
It's kind of just aching all the time, sometimes even throbbing, like
okay.
At the end of the day.
Okay.
And that's really the only words I can.
Okay. Okay. So besides your pain in the ankle and maybe a little bit above, is there anything that you feel up towards your knee, towards your hip, anything on the other side of the leg, or maybe down towards your toes?
No, not at all.
Not at all.
No.
Okay. Okay. sign. So now I'm just going to go over with you what I have so far. I just want to clarify that your pain where you tell me is exactly where I'm noting it at. So just to show you, you're showing that your throbbing and your aching pain is felt right in here. So there's nothing above towards the knee, nothing below towards your toes, or and nothing on the other side of the leg.
Not at all.
Okay.
No.
Okay. Great. Great. Okay. And is there anything that you can think of that makes this pain worse?
Worse? Well, when I go down the stairs, it hurts really bad.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was also given a boot by my grandmother. She actually had one too. So when I wear that and take it off, it really hurts.
Okay. And when do you typically take that boot off?
I usually take it off like when I'm at home already. So like at the end of the day from school and
okay.
work, I'll take it off. Then.
So you wear it typically throughout the entire day?
Pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It looks really, really ugly like when I take it off. Too.
Yeah. I can imagine, but we're gonna work hard to get that to look better for you. That way you can feel better about
oh, really?
About your ankle and get that pain subsided. Also,
that's awesome.
Is there anything else that you could think of that might cause that pain?
Well, I guess when I'm walking on it all day, it really hurts. Then
okay,
even when I have the boot on,
mm-hmm.
so when I'm at work and at school trying to get to places, it still hurts. Then it hurts even more when I take it off. So to be honest with you.
Okay. So is there anything that you would say that makes that pain feel better?
Yeah, what I do in the morning is I usually take Tylenol for like the pain and stiffness.
Mm-hmm.
And then also I will use like that Epsom salt stuff.
Okay.
And I'll
okay.
soak that in like with my bath time.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can also like prop it up. I saw that on Google that might help and that I guess works.
Okay. Yeah, definitely.
So,
yeah. I can see why you would think that would work. I'm glad that that's helping you. So how long are you soaking it in Epsom salt, would you say?
Probably about 30 minutes.
30 minutes. And how long would you prop it up for usually?
Probably about the same time. I kind of prop it up when I'm watching Netflix. So
okay,
I'm already doing it,
yeah.
I guess.
And when you say that you get pain from walking and walking upstairs, how would you rate that pain?
Hurts really bad, actually. I'd probably say maybe 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10. And how long would you say usually it takes for that 7 out of 10 to kind of decrease?
With medication, I'd probably say about an hour.
An hour, okay.
An hour. Yeah.
I'm glad you are taking something for that pain and that it's, I see that it's helping you. We'll get to that a little bit later. But I want to talk about how your pain is in the morning. You said you had some stiffness, is that right?
Yeah, some pain and stiffness in the morning, and it hurts really bad in the morning.
Okay,
yeah.
How would you rate that pain when you wake up?
Oh gosh, I'd probably say about an 8 out of 10.
Okay, 8
yeah,
out of 10.
Definitely.
So when you feel this 8 out of 10, is this when you take that medication that you were seeing?
Yeah, usually I take about 3 Tylenol, and it helps it go away.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of the only thing I do in the morning.
In the morning, okay.
Yeah.
And throughout the day, how would you describe your pain?
Throughout the day, I take a lot of medication, so it does help out, but it still hurts, like at work and at school. It hurts throughout the day, honestly.
Okay. And throughout the day, again, how would you rate that pain from the same scale that we talked about?
Well, it's not as bad when I wake up, but it still does hurt, so I'd probably say maybe about a 5 out of 10.
Okay, 5.
Yeah.
And at night, how would you rate your pain when you're going to bed, when you're done with school and work?
I'd probably say about the same.
About
yeah,
the same.
Maybe even, yeah, about 5 out of 10.
Okay.
Yeah.
And earlier you described like kind of a throbbing and aching pain. Does that throbbing and aching pain stay consistent throughout the entire day, would you say? Or do you
do
ever
you mean,
feel
like,
anything?
Does it change?
Yeah, do you ever feel anything else besides the aching and the throbbing?
No, pretty much just that.
Okay, just that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Have a pretty good understanding of your pain level so far throughout your day, which is awesome. I think that's going to really help me to help you with your ankle pain. So after looking at your intake form, I saw that you smoke. Is that right?
Yes, I do. I'm really really trying to stop, but yeah.
Okay, and how many cigarettes or packs do you smoke, would you say, about a week?
Gosh, well, not so many right now. It's usually when I'm stressed out, but it's pretty rare.
Okay, how many cigarettes would you say in a day that you smoke?
Jeez, I'm a little embarrassed, but probably about 2 cigarettes a day.
Yeah, that's okay. I appreciate you sharing that information with me. So 2 a day, and I'm glad that you want to quit. I think that's an excellent step, and I could definitely help you with that if you'd like to stop. I could definitely guide you in those steps. And I also saw that you checked off feeling down at home. Could you explain that a little bit more for me?
Yeah, so my mother and my grandmother, they're pretty strict, so they don't let me go out dancing, and they just kind of always keep me there, and I've even, like, tried to get my own place, mm-hmm. and they just are nothing for it, so
okay.
It's really frustrating.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I can imagine how frustrating that is, especially if it's something that you really like to do aside from school.
Yeah, exactly.
And work, yeah. And I also saw that you checked off difficulty sleeping because of your pain. Could you explain that a little bit more for me?
Yeah, it's just I don't like taking medication all the time, and I have to take it, you know, throughout the day, and I take it at night. But sometimes it takes a while for it to kick in,
mm-hmm.
because I take it right before bed,
mm-hmm.
So it kind of keeps me up a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is there anything that you do when you wake up from that pain to make it go away and to help you go back to sleep?
Well, I figured that the medication just wears off, so I just take more.
Okay, just
yeah.
take more of that. Good. And have you noticed any changes in your eating habits or in your bowel movements or anything?
No changes.
No changes? Okay, good. Great. And I also saw that you had an x-ray done. About how long ago was that?
The x-ray was 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I see that was a negative. So that is a great sign.
Yes.
That shows that I could definitely help with this. And you also mentioned a lot of the medication that you're taking is the over-the-counter Tylenol.
Mm-hmm.
So how often a day would you say you take that?
You know, I usually just kind of follow the label, so I don't take any more than it tells me to.
Okay.
Just kind of when I need.
Yeah. No, that's definitely something good to follow there if you definitely don't know. So how would you describe what happened to your ankle for me?
Well, this is so silly, but I was riding on a golf cart. I say riding, but I was racing.
Mm-hmm.
I was racing some of my friends, and I guess I didn't see a curb, and it kind of just rolled over on my ankle. And
mm-hmm.
I thought I shattered it, but it wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
But it just started hurting really bad after that.
Mm-hmm. And how long ago did this happen?
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks,
mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, did you at least win the race?
Nope.
Didn't win it. Oh, man, okay. Okay, so have you had any previous injuries to this leg, or maybe to the other leg, or to your hip or knee or anywhere else?
Well, just the patella injury,
mm-hmm.
A long time ago, but it doesn't really.
Okay, so just that, when you were
right.
10 years old?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. And what exactly would you hope to get out of physical therapy? What are some goals that you want to get back to?
Well, I really, really just want to go dancing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really worried that the time off already that I've had will make me lose my job.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of pay for community college that way. And if I can't get back to work soon, then
okay, yeah. Those are all things that definitely I can see why you're worried about those. But I do want you to understand that the ankle pain that you feel right now, it's going to get better, and I'm going to be able to help you with that so that you could get back to doing those things as soon as possible. So is there anything that you could think of at the moment that you could add to anything else? Besides just what you do for fun, besides your hobbies, besides any of the goals that you've listed, is there anything else that you want to add?
I think that's everything. You've been very helpful.
Okay, great, great. And how would you best say that you learned?
Learning, I'd probably say, well, in school at least, I like looking at pictures and drawing pictures.
Okay, so you're more of like a visual learner?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Would demonstration help you?
Yeah.
Do you think? Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good. Awesome. Well, I think I have a pretty thorough examination of what you're feeling today. So I'm going to take this information and we're going to work our best to get you back to your activities and your work and dancing and all that.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.